For those of you who are taking thesis seminar, I wanted to give you some ideas about how you might interpret some of the writing issues that were detected by Grammarly. Remember, Grammarly is a tool that I'm using, one of many types of feedback that you're going to receive from your academic text, but it's typically used at the end of the writing process, after decisions have been made regarding coherency, organization, making sure that you have good topic sentences, evidence sentences are placed within the body paragraph, along with analysis sentences, and also final concluding, summarizing, or linking sentences at the end of each body paragraph. So think of Grammarly as really the last effort in kind of cleaning up your text. So if you know that, based on other forms of feedback that you've received from me prior, that you need to make some structural changes to your text, maybe you need to reorder certain sentences, maybe some paragraphs need to be divided into two paragraphs, maybe some text needs to be removed altogether. Okay, so depending on those situations, of course, you need to make those changes first and take that in consideration when you're looking at feedback related or writing issues that are detected by Grammarly. Okay, so again, it doesn't make sense to try to correct the grammar if the text is not even going to be there, or you're really going to be moving text around completely. You want to make those changes first and then take into consideration any of the writing issues that were detected by Grammarly. Now, let's say that there are no issues with the structure and the sentences are going to remain the way they are, then you still need to make a decision on a case-by-case basis. Do I need to make changes or not? Okay, if you're looking at feedback, if you're looking at certain issues that were detected by Grammarly and you're not sure if those changes need to be made, then either you need to leave it the way it is, or two, you could ask. You can ask me or ask someone else or look into it. Maybe go onto YouTube and find additional information perhaps about that particular writing issue. But my point here is only make changes that were to your writing. Only make changes to your writing where Grammarly maybe detected certain issues. Only make those changes if you know what you're doing, if you're comfortable with those changes, if you know yourself that making those changes is going to improve your writing. Okay, it's very important, again, that you don't just arbitrarily go through and make those changes. Okay, this will not improve your writing. If you think that Grammarly is going to be the end all, be all, and just blanketly go through and make all those changes, that's going to be a mistake. All right, so just take that in consideration. I think it's a good tool when used with the other forms of feedback that I'm going to provide, and the items that we have mentioned at length that are included in the literature review guide and the meal plan pages in particular. Right, these points are mainly the issues that I see. Most of the forms of feedback that I provide are included on these two pages, but Grammarly is just one additional tool that will help you if you take this into consideration, that you're taking each writing issue on a case-by-case basis and you're making the best decision, again, given that you've already made changes to the organization, the transitions, and so on.